Hello, folks. By now, most of us are fully aware of Volodymyr Zelensky's story, the president of Ukraine, who's rallied his troops and helped inject a fighting spirit into his armed forces in the face of a much bigger, more powerful enemy. We also know Russia's story, or rather that of Vladimir Putin, who has brought Europe to the brink of World War III. Amongst his many reasons why is the claim that he wants to denazify Ukraine, even though Ukraine's democratically elected President Zelensky is Jewish and lost relatives in the Holocaust. As the world's leading powers pick sides, one nation has been surprisingly quiet: Israel. A few weeks ago, over at the toothless UN, Israel chose not to back a US-led resolution to condemn Russia's invasion. Why? Because it's trying to play the global mediator and maintain positive relations with both sides. In other words, it's sitting on the fence. But that's proving increasingly hard to do as atrocities mount, not to mention alleged war crimes, which is a touchy subject for Israel, given it's been accused of that very thing during its wars in Gaza. I covered three of those wars. Zelensky is getting frustrated. He said on the weekend to Israeli Prime Minister Naftali Bennett, "You can mediate, but cannot mediate between good and evil." I could ask, why we are not receiving protection from Israel? Why are we not getting your Iron Dome that would protect the Jews of Ukraine? Why hasn't Israel joined the sanction regime against Russia? They may seem like reasonable questions, but here are the answers. And it's all about protecting your own patch, first and foremost. Israel stopped an attempt by the US to transfer several batteries of its Iron Dome missile defense system to Ukraine, because Israel fears that would damage its relationship with Russia. The Iron Dome intercepts about 90% of incoming rockets, but it's a joint US-Israeli project, so any sale to a third party needs approval from all sides. The Iron Dome is also only really effective against short-range missiles, and as we've seen in Ukraine, it may struggle to handle the heat and power of those Russian strikes. Why would it be concerned about damaging its relationship with Russia, though? Well, this is the main reason for its reluctance to get involved. The answer is Syria. A highly complex arrangement has been struck between former Prime Minister Netanyahu and Vladimir Putin, in which Israel was allowed to target Iranian and Hezbollah forces in Syria, so long as it didn't target Russian troops. In return, Russia, which has scaled back its Syrian operation, can pursue its own military objectives to support the Assad regime as long as it doesn't target Israel. Whatever it is, it seems to be working, so Israel doesn't want to upset that balance and put that deal in jeopardy. I spoke to Australia's former ambassador to Israel, Dave Sharma, this week, and he highlighted these issues, but he believes Israel could still push back against Russia.
Israel's dilemma is here that they rely upon cooperation with Russia to operate against targets in Syria effectively. And this is what they're trying to safeguard here, that they make sure they can continue to operate freely over the skies of Syria without being targeted by Russian air defence systems.
Right.
Obviously, I think they would be appalled by Russia's actions against Ukraine, but this is a very real politic approach they're having to take towards this conflict. I recognise it's complicated for them, but I would like to see them take a stronger stance of public condemnation of Russian action here.
The two countries have a long history. Russian is the third most spoken language in Israel, after Hebrew and Arabic, with hundreds of thousands of Russians living there, while about 100,000 Israeli citizens live in Russia. So it's a fine line. India is also walking that diplomatic tightrope at the moment. It abstained from UN resolutions because it has a strategic relationship with Russia, primarily because of the volume of weapons it purchases from Putin. India is its biggest customer. So here's the dilemma for the West. If nations are too critical of its allies, including India or Israel, does that then drive our friends to have an even closer relationship with Russia? Is that something that can be accepted or afforded, particularly as the world waits to see what China's next move will be? Something to think about anyway. Thanks for watching. To support this channel, please like, share, and subscribe below, and I'll see you next week.